Which show? Baywatch. Speechless right now.
No, you know what? We followed the game plan for 60 minutes. We got down two quick goals there. They got lucky on the first one. They hit Silver Escape. They went to the guy back door and he had an open net. And then, you know, give credit to young Squires there. Had a nice shot under the bar there on the Boosh. And you know what? The guys just stuck to the program and kept going and plugging away and outworked them. That was the main thing we've been saying for since day one. So you got to play for 60 minutes. You don't give up. You compete. You got to do that. And when this team does compete, we have a chance to win.
It was nice to see the team play such a complete game tonight, especially after, like you say, we went two goals down pretty quickly and in past times, sort of like folded, especially the game in Cardiff. Do you think the likes of Drew Bannister has brought in such a good defensive fit, or is it just a full team effort?
It's the full team. I mean, we're all in it together. And whoever's in that room, we stick together. It's not two guys or three guys. It's 20 guys in a dressing room. Our 20 guys have to go in the same night. No one can have a night off because this group, we need to compete as a team to win hockey games, and we did tonight.
Once again, nice to see Kalnikov in the first line scoring a few goals tonight. The power play seemed to be pretty spot on tonight. Have you been practicing that?
Yeah, I mean, we've been going over everything this week. Been going over the systems. I mean, Drew was first week to practice with us, so we did a lot of work, and you know, it pays off. I think we got a group that we got to remind everybody what we do, what our systems are, and go over them. And yeah, no, we practiced the power play, and it clicked tonight. Some nights it doesn't click, but tonight it did click, so it was nice to see.
Yeah, there was no stupid turnovers tonight or cross ice passes, which are getting pinched all the time by other teams. Have you been practicing that as well?
Well, every game we talk about it, nothing up the middle, and I think sometimes we doze off and we throw one up the middle, and for some reason, every time we make a mistake, it goes to the back of our net, so, you know, hockey's a game of mistakes, it happens. You watch any level of hockey, EPL, NHL, AHL, they all make mistakes, and you're never going to be perfect, but, you know, that's one thing we preach, is make sure you keep it out of the middle.
Did extremely well on the old penalty kill as well tonight, killing a few 5-on-3s thanks to some refereeing decisions which looked like it was evened out towards the end. once again, a couple of 5-on-3s, that must take out the lads.
Yeah, I mean, we want to be disciplined, we want to be the most disciplined team in the league, and you know, when shove comes to push, I mean, we're not going to back down either, but we want to be disciplined. We want to stay out of the penalty box. This league is all about special teams, and if you look at the Sheffields, the Nottingham, the Coventry, the Belfast, every team, their power plays are extremely good, so you have to be disciplined, and, you know, we can't keep getting shorthanded 5-on-3, and yeah, some of those calls were iffy. I mean, I think Karst might have helped him out there a little bit, but you know what, he gave us some power plays too, and we just capitalised on ours.
It's nice to see Rob Gopke being quiet tonight, because he's been a bit of a thorn in the side of the whole Stingrays, scoring a hatful of goals in previous games. Was that a plan to tie him down?
Yeah, I mean, we circled their key players, and you know, Simon's had some good games against us, Talbot, and Glupke, and Ligui, who was out tonight. He's a big part of their offense. They really miss him out there, but you know, you key on those guys, and you got Tate, and you got Dowd, and you got Campbell, and you know, the list just goes on over there. So.
I thought it was pretty damn decent of us not to break the code and go overboard with the Steelers tonight, only scoring 7 goals against them.
You know what, we just kept going, and you know, if we scored, we scored. I mean, we weren't going to stop. We want to win a hockey game, we want to put on a show at home, and you know, Cardiff didn't stop after 6 or 7. They kept working even harder when they were scoring goals, so I don't know if there even is a code out there.
Well said. Coming out on tomorrow's night's match against the Nottingham Panthers, apparently there's been a bit of a mass brawl at Nottingham versus Coventry game, and a few players have been kicked out of the game, including a couple of the big heavyweights, which hopefully will make our game easier tomorrow, but obviously we'll have to wait and see if any appeals, which will normally come in.
I'm sure they'll get away with it, so. You know, if it was us, we'd probably be all suspended, and then Nottingham, they'll be playing. playing tomorrow probably. So no, I guess there was a big brawl, and I guess they ran Coventry's goalie a couple of times, and then Crookshank ran their goalie, and I guess both benches cleared. And I guess there's more fighting now in the third period too. So hopefully Nottingham loses a few more players for tomorrow.
Yeah, that'd be a shame. Once again, going on to the lighter note, we finish off. Has anybody got any dodgy tashes this week?
Trevor Reid lost the Mustache Boy, so it's his turn to grow this month. So should be a good one.
So look forward to Trevor Reid's dodgy tash. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, round of applause for the great winning coach. Thank you. So we don't know the score, 7-2.